I smelled something else. I smelled Baker. Not Baker, your morning muffin maker. Baker James III. Now, Baker James III is the counsel for Exxon Mobil Corporation. He is, in addition, the senior counsel to Carlyle Group. He is also the, you know, consigliere to the Republican Party, the guy who boasted once in front of one of our BBC reporters, "I'm the guy that stole the election for George Bush in Florida." He was joking, of course. And he and his firm are the lawyers on a very important case. You may know that the victims of the September 11th attack, the families of the victims can't do anything. The families of the victims have sued the government of Saudi Arabia for financing Al-Qaeda, because Osama apparently didn't put the hijackings on his credit card. The money came out of the Arabian Peninsula with the full knowledge of the Saudi Defense Ministry. And so the families of the victims sued. Baker is the lawyer on the case. Now, he represents the Saudis against the families of the victims. The president has given him an office at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue, right in the White House. And if you doubt that, I called myself and said, you know, I was kind of astonished. How do you, you know, here we have a representative of a foreign nation and an oil company with an office in the White House. Cheney's bunker ain't even at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue. And the White House did confirm it. And they also said, not only that, but sometimes the president lets Baker use the Oval Office desk while the president plays on the rug. That one I made up. That last part. But he does have the office there. But how did I know Baker? I sniffed Baker, and it didn't smell like Washington. See, 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue is his satellite office. This was created in the nation's capital, Houston, okay, where his main office is. In fact, where he has something called the James Baker III Institute. So I found out that, in fact, this was written by oil company executives at the James Baker III Institute with advice from the Council on Foreign Relations. Really, I'm not kidding. And by the way, how do I know that? Because I spoke with the Baker people, and I spoke with the oil company executives, and they told me that. Now, in all fairness, I should say that they didn't tell me that. In fact, the Baker Institute lawyer called Harper's Magazine when they published my BBC report, and they called, and so did a lawyer for the executive of a major oil corporation, saying, never spoke to Greg Palast. So Harper said, we will retract the story. Just tell us what part of this audio tape is not you. and NPR told me, we don't do that. And I said, I know.